In the country of Greece, on the island of Paros, lived a man who made objects of tin in his shop. He'd sit at his workbench with tin snips and hammer. When passers-by peered in his windows, they'd stop and admire the shapes of his watering cans, as well as his lanterns with patterns punched in, that glowed when a candle was placed down inside of them, casting their shadows cut out of the tin. Each Friday at 5, he would close down his shop. He'd shower, put on his white shirt and black pants. Then off to the square where the music was playing, he'd meet friends and family, and all would then dance. And the tin tinker sailed round the tiled dance floor, a smile on his face with his head held so high. With his arms open wide and his masterful hands so gracefully spinning, you'd think he could fly. Nobody can dance like the tin tinker can, with his black cap and elegant mustache so trim. He so gracefully glided across the dance floor, your eyes couldn't stop watching him. To work in his shop, making toys for the girls and the boys in his town. He loved to make doves with their movable wings that would flap with the twist of a key turning round. And holiday ornaments, bright shapes of stars with decorative motifs carved into the tin. Some hung from the hooks that he placed in the ceiling, while others were stacked near the door in a bin. The last time I saw him, I went to his shop in search of a lantern to light up my night. And he smiled as he carefully wrapped up my purchase, his eyes meeting mine, such a beautiful sight. Though years have now passed and the tin tinker's gone, his grandchildren still do the work that he did. And the favorite toy that they all love to make is the wind-up man dancing, who's made out of tin. Nobody can dance like the tin tinker can, with his black cap and elegant mustache so trim. He so gracefully glided across the dance floor, your eyes couldn't stop watching him. Your eyes couldn't stop watching him.